So how's your day been?
It's been pretty good, Nick. People are always, they're asking me, oh, where's the next Isaac episode? Where's the next Isaac episode? It's like tomorrow's a big one or something like that.
I don't know why they would get that impression.
I had no idea. I mean, is it some kind of milestone that we hit tomorrow, if we do hit it?
No, I don't think so.
I don't know.
It's probably the day you die to a bomb.
What do we say to death, Nick?
Walk into the AIDS booth twice.
The one time I need you to make a Game of Thrones reference, you don't make a Game of Thrones reference.
I can't do it. I can't do it on command. I'm like a cat. I do the opposite of what you tell me.
What's up with our Skype conversation today? Dan Giesling just pops in there and calls us all Lannisters. He says you're a bunch of Lannisters. I don't even know what the fuck that means, Dan Giesling.
He was shouting you out for being too polite was one thing.
I saw that.
I don't think that factors in. But he said, like, how did the race go with Nick? And you were like, you know, it was close. And by close, I mean not close.
Well, no, because I said it was close, to be polite. And then he said, how close? And I had to be honest. Honesty, in that case, on a second question, trumps politeness.
I came back and was like, it wasn't close at all. He beat my ass.
I'm going
like,
to rip your innards out through your bunghole.
Right, but you need to say it. I can't say I beat his ass.
Well, I did. Thankfully, I had your back on that one. It's the other side of being polite. You got to be polite in return. I
think that's very true.
And it all works out in the end. Thank you, Dude Bro 31. 12 months in a row, you made the year.
And thank you, Hosey Nader, for the same thing, but 1 month in a row. But, you know, every journey of 12 months starts with a single step. Starts with a single sub. I changed the game name. You should go look at the game name. I changed the game name. You refreshed it. It's not working for you. Apparently, a Lannister always pays his debts.
All right, what's your debt?
I don't know. I mean, I'm debt-free, I believe, so...
Debt-free is the way to be.
I guess I have,
Ask me.
I guess I have paid my debts, but have I always paid my debts? I mean, eventually, I suppose. You know, if you got student loans, it's not like a Lannister pays his debts back instantly. That's a lot of money. Maybe more like a Lannister pays his debts in a reasonable time frame, as listed in the schedule provided by Fannie Mae.
Or Freddie Mac.
Or Freddie Mac. Either one of those.
Either or.
Personably named student loan companies. We actually don't have... I don't think we have private student loan companies in Canada.
Well, you should get on board. They're pretty great, I guess.
Yeah, that's... I'm always hearing... I'm seeing people tweet. I love Fannie Mae and Freddie Mac. I'm a huge fan of those companies.
People tweet that a lot about them in particular.
NL return slab, please. NL, why did you take Libra? Did you take Libra, Nick?
Yeah, I did.
Fuck yeah, man.
Got a lot of keys and bombs out of it.
Exactly.
So that kind of was where I needed to be from that.
Just ball out of control with Libra. It don't matter. You know what is the best thing about Libra? It turns every stat upgrade into an all stats upgrade. Mind you, it kind of dilutes the effect, but still.
Seems alright to me.
There's OSAP, but I don't think that's private. Yeah, that was my assumption as well, is that OSAP is not private. I think it's public.
What? OSAP is... the secret room, then?
Pardon me?
The secret room's all weird.
What, did you find your balls in it?
No, I didn't. I don't have balls.
Woo!
I broke Duck Game yesterday.
That's true.
You know, the answer was that I had hidden the folder in my documents because I was cleaning shit up and I didn't realize that would break the game.
Why are you hiding folders, though?
Because my documents gets filled with freaking random game save files.
Yeah, why are you hiding the folders, though?
Because I actually use that.
I have never heard of anybody hiding files on their computer. At least if it's not a computer.
I like
that
it to be clean.
I mean, it's not really clean, though. It's just kind of, you're sweeping it under the bed.
It's where I don't need to see it.
I mean, I suppose so,
range up. All right.
But I'll admit, look, it's not on you, but it is funny that, it breaks the game just for having a hidden folder.
I don't really understand why it breaks the game either, because as far as I was understanding, like, hiding a folder just doesn't change anything about the structural hierarchy of things.
You should really actually submit that as a bug report. Because I imagine that's the kind of thing where the developer would be like, I never would have tested for that. If I was a game developer and someone was like, hey, I'm having a bug. If I have a hidden folder, then the game doesn't work at all. That's the point where I would be like, that's strange. Do you
it
think
got
maybe...
to the part where we would load textures in the loading bar in the beginning and it would just crash.
Is it possible that one of the folders you hid was, used for Duck Game?
No, it was the Duck Game folder.
I'm gonna rip your
innards
out through your
bum. Oh, that's the one you hid.
Yeah, when games make a file folder that just stores a save game there, I tend to hide them because it usually doesn't matter.
See, I can 218. I hope I got your name correct there. But now that I know it's not just a random hidden folder, it's actually...
it's not random. It's Duck Game.
It's the Duck Game folder. Now that seems a little bit more reasonable.
It is more reasonable. I'm not blaming them entirely. It was pretty much my fault.
I think it had been misrepresented from the start.
Well, I may have just said it wrong. They do that a lot.
No, that's okay. You don't need to worry about it. It's still messed up, but I don't know. We've got a hidden folder. What are you using your documents folder, man? You got documents in there?
Yeah, keep documents in there.
The documents folder is just where you keep everything. They should just call it all my shit.
I don't know. I've got my own setup. I like it the way I keep it, and I try to get it back to that position whenever I can.
Are you one of those guys, you got like an MP3 collection, and it's all tagged properly, like
it's
everything?
All tagged properly, all have the exact correct names, yeah. And the album art is at least 300 by 300 size.
What? You've been resizing the album art?
I also changed them so they're not bitmaps. I make them all JPEGs to be standardized. I'm sorry, I've got a problem.
Nick, that's... as someone who is very unorganized, what you have just said to me is mind-blowing, and also, I think, like, positive, like, I'm very impressed, but at the same time, that sounds like the exact opposite of the way I live my life.
I understand. I'm not saying this is the life for everyone.
Doubtlessly.
It's a big problem for me a lot of the time, because it makes so much extra work, and if anyone else gets involved with my stuff, it's like, now I've got to deal with that, too.
You got to train them.
They won't be trained. Everyone pushes back against that.
I can imagine. They're like, well, this one's just a bitmap. I don't need to make... you make a PNG?
No, I'd make them JPEGs, although PNG would actually be more responsible. I should really do that, but I stuck with the system I made years ago.
Is your music collection in MP3, or do you got some, like, Ogg Vorbis?
It's MP3. Okay. If I went that far, like, I would probably lose sleep over how much time that would take.
You're not going full Ogg?
No.
Or FLAC?
Well, the... source files aren't going to be that good in the first place, so I'd be wasting my time to do that.
Okay. That's fair. I was one of those guys, you know, back in the day. Look, take me away, RIAA. I'm out of your jurisdiction, motherfuckers. I was using BearShare, Kazaa Lite, Napster.
BearShare. LimeWire?
You can only try me as a youngster because I was like 13 at the time. I may have used some LimeWire in my day. So all of my files look like, you know, number 0, number 4, dot... Uncle yeah. Cracker spelled with like 6 K's, follow me dot MP3, but actually it's a WMA or something like that.
Then you download it, it's just like 26 megabytes of malware.
Yeah, it's actually...
not even an MP3 in there at all.
But it was better, regardless, than follow me by Uncle Cracker.
Well, yeah, I guess. Trying to look at the bright side of things.
At least I didn't have to listen to follow me by Uncle Cracker.
Thank you very much, Silken218, for the subscription. Really appreciate it. Let's get some Franker Z's for you, just to mix it up.
I think we need to, you know, everyone's always like, All-Star Man, Steve Harwell, is the Guy Fieri of the music industry.
But he's the same person.
I think you gotta give Uncle Cracker some Guy Fieri-isms as well. It really would not... we all know that Guy Fieri's favorite song is, Kid Rock's cover of Sweet Home Alabama, or, you know, interpretation of Sweet Home Alabama.
You all know that, so you don't even need to say it.
However, I think he's got a really soft spot for that Uncle Cracker song that's like, you know, give me the people as in free my soul, I wanna get lost in the rock and roll and drift away.
I remember that. That was not a bad rendition.
I feel like that is probably Guy Fieri, like, sheds a little tear when he listens to that. And I'm not even trying to make fun of Guy Fieri. It's nice that he's so in touch with his emotional side.
I feel like he goes to the emotional side for, like, a split second, then he gets this, like, inexorable rage passes over his body.
Because he's feeling emotions.
Right, which is, like, you shouldn't do that. So his tips turn bright red, and then he shoots laser beams out of his eyes.
His tips turn bright red. That's how you know he's excited.
Well, I mean, I imagine his tips are like a moon
ring. I'm gonna rip you in
and
zap through
your bunghole. And when he's in a neutral position, they're the usual blonde frosted tips deal, right? And then he gets in a different mood, it changes up.
Brady Rocher, thank you very much for the subscription. Nick, I may die on my run.
Don't do it.
I've made a bit of a big mistake.
Did you gamble too far?
I took Book of Belial.
Oh, I took that.
With Libra. I took everything on that deal. So
I only took the Book of Belial there.
I got super low. And then, also, I feel like Book of Belial is really bad with Libra. Like, when you use it... Yeah, I'm dead.
I didn't really think about that.
I just went too hard on that one. All That's right. me. I was acting a little silly. Can you give me the seat again in just a moment here?
Yep, take your time. I'm going to say thank you to Willie Van Kerr 69 for the 2 months in a row. Thank you very much for that. If we could get maybe some T-tours in the chat,
Nick,
for you.
I need to see.
Ready?
Yes.
J0Q2.
Okay.
FDXL.
Sweet.
Good luck.
Let's begin. I don't think I'll need it. I think I just need to not be a total idiot. If I just, like, don't take everything on that deal with the devil, life is a lot easier. Probably not Libra as well.
Guys, he didn't throw the streak. Stop.
Now I have to deal with this shit every time people go, whoa, I saw on Twitch that the streak is over. How is the streak still going? And then the people are like, oh, it's Northern Lion cheating on the streak? Like, no, you're believing things you read on the internet, which is almost exclusively a bad practice.
Tinfoil boys.
Tinfoil? Oh, dude, a tinfoil hat would be awesome as an emoticon.
Did you know that there's actually a tinfoil hat in Duck Game? That's what the plate of ashes is, actually.
That's the plate of ashes.
Remember the plate of ashes when we were in the tournament and we were like, that's a plate of ashes. This game's hardcore.
Yeah. It was not ashes, it was a tinfoil hat.
Tinfoil hat. All I found out because I was actually using the level editor last night.
Oh.
And the item was named tinfoil hat.
That makes a lot of sense. I bet it protects you from mind control, I suppose.
That makes a lot of sense. I didn't really think too hard about what it did.
I think it probably protects you from mind control. So I'm going to.
Well, we know mind control is real in this case.
Yes. Well, and it's real in real life, too. It's contrails.
Oh, the jets leave behind the chemtrail.
The jets leave behind the chemical trail to numb the populace into inaction. We all know that. I mean, it's basically proven, so.
So it just, like, filters down in the air, and then it's just in our air that we breathe?
Yeah, they release it at high concentrations, but then it diffuses down in the atmosphere, and,
Oh, and because of homeopathy, it's actually more effective that way. Once it dilutes into the air, it becomes very, very small.
Call it homeopathy?
Yeah.
No, man.
The belief that if you... you know, put something soluble into a bit of liquid and you keep re-diluting it until there's nothing left.
It's homeopathy, though.
Oh.
Homeo.
No, it's not.
Homeopathy is like, I don't even know where to go with that. Skip Libra, take Libra. Skip Libra, take Libra. I'm going to skip Libra.
Did you take Libra then?
No, I skipped it because it almost got me killed.
Skip it, then take it.
I may skip it and then take it. I'm looking forward to deal with
it. Come
the devil,
on,
though.
Kids. Come gather around. So you had just skipped into town.
Is that skip it?
The best thing of all is the Libra on this ball. Yeah, it's skip it.
My skip it was a great friend of mine as a child.
I'm glad to hear it.
Back when, you know, in my generation, we still had to be tricked into physical exercise. It's like, hey, put this ball and chain on your leg. Kind of swing it around and then jump over it once per rotation. And people were like, well, I'm not going to do that. And they're like, well, what if we put a counter on it that goes up, like, every time you
see
it?
That's the very best thing of all,
yeah,
actually.
Exactly. And then they go, oh, shit, you're going to put a counter on it? Well, I'll try it a couple times. All right, well, I got, like, 11. I definitely can beat that. And then, like, 12 hours later, you're like, oh, shit.
I got exercise. Fuck.
Yeah. Damn it, you tricked me into exercising.
Pandora's Box Caves 1. Take it, leave it.
Take it and use it right away. Well, it depends what your spacebar item is. Book of Belial? Take it,
Book
use
of Belial.
It. Take it, use it.
Screw. Nice.
Pretty good.
Worth it. And
I like this. He'll probably lose the streak on an Eden run with 1 HP LMAO. Are you laughing at your suggestion? Your completely plausible suggestion of how the streak will eventually end? He'll probably have the ham sandwich for lunch today, LMAO. I don't understand the joke here.
I mean, if you watch the episode, Northern Lion actually posited that exact same idea in the last episode. So
it's a very likely original way for it to end, I think.
That's just one of those moments where, like, the clench begins right at the start of that run if it happens.
Yeah, you can relieve the clench sometimes. I've had many clench relieving runs lately.
Oh, I've seen one pretty recently where you got Dr. Fetus.
Yeah, I don't like to talk about that run.
That was pretty traumatizing. I would never take Dr. Fetus again after
that was the one where after it happened, I popped into... Hey, got me again. I popped into Skype and was like, I just did a run that's going to make everyone stand up and cheer.
Oh, yeah, I remember when that happened.
And I think in some ways it did.
mean, we're still talking about it to this day.
I did get
days later.
Messages from people that were like, holy crap, my butt was clenched during that run. I'm like, yeah, my butt was clenched during that run as well. I don't want to restart my computer right now, okay? We can do that later.
I have to admit, though, I mean, it was a little bit ruined for me, the fact that I already knew you didn't lose, so.
That's fair.
But then again, that's the price I pay.
I needed to tell somebody, because that episode wasn't going up for like a week, and I was like shaking after I finished it.
Oh, I don't blame you. I could hear it in your voice.
Yeah, it was...
You're a little quivery there.
A little quivery, thinking that it was probably over.
The end, there was like a good 10-15 seconds of silence before you started talking again.
Yeah,
like letting your heartbeat work again.
Pretty much, yeah. And it's some scary runs lately. A little scary. NL didn't take theirs options this time. That's okay. I don't need theirs options. I can hear it in the crackle. I can hear it coming in the air tonight. You got to give me a moment to pause it here.
Yeah, definitely taking growth hormones.
Oh, that's where I died.
What, to Krampus?
Yeah.
That guy's a chump. He hardly ever kills me anymore.
I only had one spirit heart, and then I psyched myself out.
Oh, okay. He got you with the four-way?
Ah, shit. I'm in exactly the same situation, Nick.
Why would you do that?
I took experimental treatment this time, because the other option, I think it was synth oil, didn't show up. And then it hurt myself. Like, it took 1 HP away from me. And also lowered my DPS.
Alright, I'm going to risk this room. I hope this works out for me. Wait, does Purity give me health also, or no? The Dagaz rune?
Oh, yeah, it gives you a spirit art.
Fuck, why did I just bomb into that? Alright, well, I have Book of Belial, so I don't really need the other effect from it. I may as well just use it then.
I'm still crackling.
Oh, Dead Cat. That's great.
Dead Cat is a shit item. I don't even want it.
I love so much that you almost had to be put in a position where taking Dead Cat would have ruined.
Oh, dude. Don't even get me started on that shit.
I was sitting there going, oh shit, this is the moment. He's going to start cursing my name now.
I was having nightmares over that. I was like, oh shit. It's like the exact situation that I hate. 9 lives could get me killed. It's not fair.
I didn't want you to get killed, but at the same time, there was some like pleasure that I was
taking. Oh, I could tell, you know.
You struggle a little bit there. Only because I know you always triumph in the end, that's all.
Well, not always, probably.
Very likely that you would have triumphed in the end.
There's a good chance, yeah. Is Dead Cat a cat piece? Of course Dead Cat is a cat.
It is, absolutely. It should count as 9 cat pieces if you think about it.
Yeah, you just become like 3 guppies.
You got triple guppy, trip gup.
Trip gup.
And it's just like a mirror of himself flying around in circles. Yeah, let's take this. Oh yeah, Spirit Heart City.
How's the grass?
Over there.
How's the grass
in
Spirit Heart
City? It's pretty green, actually.
Yeah?
It's pretty lovely here.
How are the girls?
They're reasonably well endowed, to be
honest. Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Well, this is gonna take a while. I love Cat Piece meta. Dude, Cat, it's just like the canonical name.
I love Moonstar.
Moonstar is a better name than Cat Piece, but they're both good.
Did you see on the NLSS Circle Jerk, somebody made a list of all the Josh names?
Oh, for real? That's awesome.
There's gotta be 15 of them on there already.
Chat, don't be mad at me for not using Book of Belial right away. I was thinking about saving it for the Krampus fight.
Chat, it's your duty to contribute to the Josh list of items. On
so there's like Moonstar and obviously Mom's Rod and everything.
There's a lot of creative ones that I forgot he even have ever said, so you gotta go back through all of the old ones and listen for them.
Oh,
Telepills? Telepills took me somewhere, okay.
Did it take you to Spirit Heart City? Because I've heard good things.
It's not as good as that place.
Oh, come on, with this damage.
This bombs are key again, I keep getting that.
Nick, this seat is Trash City. The grass is dead and so are the girls.
The grass is dead and the trees are shitty.
Yeah. Nobody lives there anymore. It's like Centralia or something.
Centralia?
Oh, Dollar Shades? Dollar Shades is a
Dollar
good one.
Shades.
That's one of my favorites. Dollar Shades. And there was another Josh one. I was talking about Centralia. Yeah, that's that like city. There was like a mine. It's in Pennsylvania, and then they like hit a huge methane vein or something.
Is that the thing Silent Hill was patterned after?
Yeah. So like nobody's lived in the town for like 100 years, and it's breaking apart or something like that. There's like huge cracks in the ground. Methane gas just pours out of them all day.
Are there still mannequins that roam the streets at night, or is that...
Yeah, I don't know if there's, like, mannequins that roam the street and, like, those scary nurses and stuff like that.
Sometimes there's a man with a giant pyramid for a head and he'll rip your skin off just because he doesn't like you.
He's kind of an asshole.
That's what I've said.
Like, I don't like to judge people, but if you rip someone's skin off just because you don't like them, you're kind of a dick in my book. But I don't know the extenuating circumstances. Maybe your parents didn't raise you right or something. Like, can't really blame you.
Chat's right, by the way. It's a coal fire, because, like, a big portion of the reason that Silent Hill is so creepy is because ash is falling all over the whole thing.
That's true. Ash Ketchum. Also known like as Red. Burning.
Red, yeah. I like to roll in, I won't even say it.
I don't know what was that.
I think you're sick of me talking about Orange is the New Black.
Oh my god.
I finally finished the series last night.
Yeah, finally! After, like... A week ago, you're like, hey,
well, I've been talking about it.
Does anyone like Orange is the New Black? I've been watching that show for 2.5 years. I guess like 3 years. Well, no, 2 years now, but it's the third season. And I still haven't finished the series. I got like maybe 6 or 7 episodes left.
Third series was so weird. The ending was bizarre.
I wouldn't know, Nick. I wouldn't know.
Yeah. Should watch it so we can talk about it. Nobody to talk about it with.
Yeah, it's only like the second most popular show on planet Earth right now.
Well, I just happen to not know anyone who's watched the last season, that's all.
It's pretty good. What have I been watching instead? I don't know. Oh, like 30 episodes of Border Security last night, that's about it.
Oh, D6 shows up, that's weird. I don't really want to re-roll the Book of Belial, maybe I can re-roll the boss item.
It's amazing to me that I have not gotten sick of Border Security yet. Every episode, I'm like, yep, that guy's smuggling noodles in, that guy's got weed, and it just, like, it's just so good, man. Like... On the last episode, there was like this couple from Alaska, and they came in on a boat, and then there was weed just in the boat, and the guy was like, oh shit, I forgot that was there, and then they're like, well, you know, you're under arrest, and he's like, oh shit, really? Like, dude,
is that what happens?
What do you think is gonna, like, if you,
I'm
are,
gonna rip your
oh,
in
Jesus,
and out through your bunghole.
ASDF, 123, thank you for the subscription. I don't care if you're gonna use drugs, but educate yourself, man. You can't just carry it across the border. That shit is gonna get you thrown in, like, pound you in the ass prison.
Oh, the federal pound you in the ass prison.
Exactly.
I heard about that in Office Space.
I was being referential.
Yeah.
So many, and other ones, like, you know, dude is just like, well, yeah, I mean, of course I've got, like, a rifle in my car. And they're like, well, you have any permits for it? And they're like, I don't carry them with me. Like, what do you think? I'm crossing an international border or something like that? But I have learned that, like, 80% of the problems with crossing the border are basically due to the fact that you have to go through Canada to get to Alaska. People are like, well, my gun is legal in the U.S., and it's legal in, you know, Alaska, which is also the U.S., but I have to drive through Canada to get to Alaska, so I got arrested. Like, that's a little fucked up. It's weird. I'm not saying you should make an exception for it, but it's a tricky one. You know, that would be, like, the last question on your border exam, for sure.
Have you ever done the thing where you're listening to somebody talk, and then you kind of, like, forget the controls of the game you've played 200, 300 hours of?
Yeah, yeah.
Because I've just done that.
Are you alive still?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just wasted a bunch of shit for no reason. This is pretty embarrassing, to be honest. I needed that bomb, actually.
NL, do you have any advice for a silly American boy moving to Montreal? It's very simple. Like, if you're just talking about advice for crossing the border, straight up, like...
Leave your drugs at home.
Don't take weed in over the border, and, like, probably don't take a gun, but you can legally take one if you got permits for it. And, you know, also, like, look it up. There you go. That's the only advice you need to get across the border anyway.
Don't take pepper spray. It's illegal in Canada.
That's true. That's been showing up all the time in border security.
People never would have even crossed my mind that would be a problem.
People will have, like, a shotgun, and will be like, well, as long as you got permits for it. But then, like, the pepper spray is actually inadmissible. Can't take it in.
They'll just kick you out of the country.
Well, they'll just make you throw out the pepper spray, probably. Unless you're
I heard that, like, they'll just kick you out. Like,
if you're being an asshole about it, you might get in trouble.
Right, well, you probably will be an asshole about it, right?
Well, I don't know. It's possible, I guess.
It's your pepper spray. Like, they can't just take your property.
They were like, okay, I felt bad because there were these hunters. And they're like, yeah, we have, like, 80 guns or whatever. And they're like, well, here's all the permits for them, so you're fine. And then they were like, well, we got this pepper spray in case a bear chases us. We can spray the pepper spray at the bear and it'll run away. And they're like, oh, sorry, you can't take that into Canada. So they're like, yeah, come in here with, like, weapons that could literally murder people. Like, mass murder. But the pepper spray is not allowed. And even the border guards were, like, shrugging their shoulders, basically. Like, it's pretty fucked up, but sorry, you can't take that in here.
It's weird the things that, like, you can get away with border security. I mean, there's all these weapons that you can take onto planes, but then there's all these non-weapons that you can't. You know, you could beat the shit out of somebody with, like, a bowling pin. You're allowed to take that on.
Are you allowed to take a bowling pin onto a flight?
You are, actually, as bizarre as that sounds. Like, if you put it in your carry-on, you're allowed to.
You're allowed to carry a bowling pin onto the...
You can also take, like, a canoe paddle. That could...
What? For real?
According to this video that I watched, yeah.
You can take a canoe paddle onto an airplane?
The whole point of the video was to sort of lampoon how dumb they are about what you're allowed not to take and not allowed to take.
I'd be pissed, man. That's going to take up, like, all the overhead space.
Smidge. I don't know how the hell you fit it at all.
Smidge of Midge, thank you for the subscription. You're allowed to bring a spear gun in your carry-on. Well, that's just ridiculous.
Thank
I don't want to have a
23 and Duck Souls very much for your subscriptions. How about some Rock Meows for you?
I feel like if you can bring a spear gun onto an airplane, look, I don't want to be too controversial, but I feel like if you can bring a gun that shoots a spear onto an airplane, by proxy, you should be allowed to bring a spear onto an airplane. And if you're able to bring a spear onto an airplane, I think I should be able to bring on hand sanitizer. That's all I'm saying.
Oh, you can as long as you put it in a see-through baggie for some reason.
I think I should be able to bring a fork on the airplane.
That seems like you're pushing it.
Or nail clippers. This is the shit that's gonna get me
crazy talk.
This is gonna get me put on the no fly list. This guy's trying to bring nail clippers onto the airplane.
I really don't understand the whole thing about why it has to be in the see-through baggie.
Oh, you can bring a spear gun, but you can't load it.
Well, what's the point of it then? How am I gonna shoot a spear? What a bunch of shit that is.
Spear gun doesn't work well close range? I don't know, man. I'd be pretty scared.
Jab it through someone's eye socket. It'll work just fine.
I'd be pretty frightened about the whole spear gun situation.
Thanks to Boddington very much. 9 months in a row. How about some Be Yourselves for Boddington?
What the fuck is Be Yourself, Nick? Except for a Soundgarden song.
It's a rare Pepe.
Is that like Meme City now?
Yeah.
I've been seeing that stupid frog everywhere. I don't get it.
I really like that
frog. I don't understand the internet. The internet is like...
Don't look on its face.
I already don't understand the internet, but then in summer vacation, the meme meta just moves too fast for me to even try to like hang with it anymore. It's like, you know, if you're in a car accident, you could try to steer out of it, but if you want like a 100% chance to not fucking die, you just go completely limp and like let it happen.
Yep, fall off a building.
Yeah, exactly. That's where I am in like summer vacation meme meta. It's just like, don't even try. In October, you can read like Know Your Meme for a couple hours and catch up.
Yeah, memes are kind of like falling off a building, if you think about it.
All I've been thinking about is that since we started the show today. Pepe is love. Okay, that's like a meme in a meme right there.
Shrek is nice.
Shrek is nice? That's like a second order meme. See, that's still following to some extent.
One thing I know. Shrek is nice.
It's all about waffle now. W-O-F-L. See, this is why like I can't hang with it. I'm still in like...
Waffle is old meta. Come on.
I'm in Don't Tase Me Bro territory still.
You don't remember Waffle?
I don't know. What's Waffle?
Waffle's Last Gray Wolf, but with the wolf spelled backwards. It's actually an old B-Rex thing.
Really?
In Symphony of the Night, he would run into the waffle, and it was actually just a wolf.
I'm gonna rip you in and zap through your bunghole!
Joke.
Luchiro Farin, thank you very much for the subscription.
I got a really strange Ipecac deal going on right now.
You got Ipecac?
Yeah, I'm like launching a million little tiny Ipecac balls everywhere.
It's a weird run, Nick.
And I just got Whipworm too, so that's gonna be fun. Thank you, Andrew LGN. What should we go back to this time? Maybe PogChamps.
I do like PogChamp.
Let's do some PogChamps for Andrew LGN. I probably just got myself killed by picking up Ipecac here, but...
Waffle is not wolf spelled backwards. Yeah, I wasn't going to say
it. It's not backwards.
you're the one who said it, Nick.
It's just the letters changed.
You said it's wolf spelled backwards, and I was like, you know what, I'm just going to let him have that one. I don't have to be that guy every time. Oh. I don't know, man. Like, I just kind of... Whenever someone tweets me and it's just like a bunch of memes, I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about, but I get it. Like, I get what the message of what you're saying is, like, I'm a silly dude. And I'm like, okay, that's cool. You can be a silly dude.
It's a lighthearted way of being a comedian without having to come up with material yourself.
Basically, yeah. You know, it's inside jokes that are shared amongst a lot of people. They're like inside-outside jokes.
Honestly, I think it's what makes our community as strong as it is. If we didn't have memes, we might not have anything.
That's what I said to our marriage counselor.
That's sad.
We're not actually seeing a marriage counselor, but we did bond over our love of memes, of course.
What's Kate's favorite meme, do you know?
Probably Yee. I know it's a little...
Yee is great, actually.
It's a little elderly at this point, but yeah, she's a big fan of Yee.
I respect that.
Yee's pretty good. She introduced me. So we've been... we'll have like a 2012 vintage Yee every now and then along with dinner, and it pairs nicely, I find, with the foie gras we eat on a regular basis.
We've mentioned meme sommeliers before. I think that should still be a thing.
Yeah. So meme liaise.
So meme liaise, yeah. High Priestess Chariot.
Nick, I think you have a good chance to beat me on this run.
Oh, only because you died like three floors in.
Right. But that's still a win, man, as far as I'm concerned. You did not die.
I didn't. I did lose one life, though, but it didn't kill me.
Yeah, I lost one, too. There's been, like, four health upgrades on this. Like, four health upgrade pills.
Yep. And I had three of them on that life that I lost.
Oh, no.
Yeah.
That's unfortunate. Now Chad is just, like, unrecognizable to me.
Have we gone into Yee territory now?
I think it's just a full assortment of this summer's hottest meme jams.
You're like a summer meme mixtape.
Exactly. Oh, dude, that'd be so good. Be real with me. I know there's like some people in, they're on like their first summer break from college. Statistically, there's got to be some people who like, they went to their first year of college this year. Did you guys have that? Because I remember being in college and being like, oh man, 2004 was so long ago. People were probably laughing at me, but did you guys like bond over r/advice animals or something like that? You go, yeah, when I was a kid, I was really into r/advice animals. That shit blows my mind because I have been exactly the same the whole way through. I've always, you know, I've been me the whole advice animals. I did no personal growth, basically. But that, for some people, is probably a watershed moment of their childhood that they no longer partake in, and as a result, it holds, you know, special significance to them.
That's kind of beautiful. I never really thought of memes that way.
Well, I'm not specifically saying with relation to memes, however, like, you know, we do it for, like, the Backstreet Boys or something like that.
They're a cultural touchstone.
They are, in a weird way, they are a cultural touchstone. I agree.
Man, think about that. That's a thing that didn't even exist only 10, 15 years ago.
I mean, they were defined by Richard Dawkins in his 1977 book, The Selfish Gene. But I guess in terms of, like, using them to make easy jokes on the internet, yeah, they're new.
Was it The Selfish Gene or was it The God Dilemma?
It was definitely The Selfish Gene.
Okay.
100%. I don't know that from being a George Dawkins fan, but I read that book in university. Because I was a dork.
Like, that makes you a dork?
It's a little dorky because it was before...
Expanding your horizons.
Not to be... Well, it wasn't. You know, I was in there for biology, so it's like pretty much right in line
pretty
with
reasonable,
my
actually.
Existing horizons. But it was before Richard Dawkins became, like, South Park-ized. People like, what's that book, nerd? I'm like, it's about biology. Fuck
I'm
you!
I'm gonna rip you in and zap through your bunghole!
MemeJams03, yeah. Thanks for the subscription.
It's weird that he had to get that treatment. Because, like, I respected him a lot at that point. Then shit got weird with him, but we don't need to get into that.
I really like the video of him playing his sweet cyber flute. Like, that is probably my favorite enduring Richard Dawkins legacy.
Alright. At least you got one.
What would be a meme jam from 03? So let's think about 03. What was the biggest movie of 2003? That was like ninth grade. Oh, 8 Mile had come out like earlier that year. Sweet Home Alabama.
I'm surprised you got like this year by year chart of everything like that.
These were 2002 movies, so I'm a little off. I'm trying to think of 2003 specifically. Is that like How to Lose a Guy in 10 Days territory, something in there?
It's the year that I graduated from high school. I don't really remember any movies that I was watching at that point.
These Nuts? No, these... That's different. Trogdor was the... Yeah, okay, Trogdor I could see. Oh, sweet. Eat My Diction, you showed up just in time. Please tell Chad to relax.
Soy Milk is not... No, this is Libra.
Oh, that's true. 2003 was the release of Return of the King as well. Or no, sorry, maybe the Two Towers. No, it was Return of the King. Yeah, definitely. That's true. You couldn't shake your dick in 2003 without running into Johnny Depp dressed as Captain Jack Sparrow. I was going to say Johnny Timberlake.
That's true about shaking your dick in Jack Sparrow, yeah.
Johnny Timberlake, you got to admit, great name for a pirate.
It's not bad, yeah.
He wouldn't be the captain. It would be like, I'm Purple Beard, and this is my swarthy first mate, Johnny Timberlake.
It's always a color in a beard, isn't it?
Well, that's the...
Usually black, which is a value.
Oh, sorry.
Is there a white beard? That's like the old aged pirate who knows the ways of the sea.
He has to, like, get a name change?
He used to be Blackbeard, now he's Whitebeard.
Someone's got to have the awkward conversation with the captain about, like, well, you know...
You're kind of over the hill, Captain.
We've been talking, and we decided, like, Blackbeard doesn't really make sense as a name, because... Like, yarr, what do you mean? Because I've got more of a soul patch these days, you mean? Oh, it's not really that, Captain. It's just get a little salt and pepper. We be engaging in the spice trade in the East Indies right now, of course. Yes, so get to the point, Timberlake.
Spices are what it was all about, man.
It's fucking people losing their lives over salt. How crazy
they
is
do
that?
It now.
Yeah, but not like over salt.
Over Burex. Same thing.
That's what I'm getting at. We've gone from people losing wars over salt, losing their lives over it, to now watching people play video games on the internet.
Game.
Exactly. All the salt factories are closing down. There used to be like a salt factory in Vancouver. It's been replaced with a restaurant. Just a trendy restaurant.
Do they serve really salty food from the
No, remnants? But they can serve as much or as little salt as they want because it's in abundance now. Really bringing your A game on these pirate jokes, NL. I like the idea of a pirate who doesn't understand why people are, like, you know, telling him that he has to change his name. It's a good character, I think.
Do pirates really need any kind of, like, officiation when it comes to name changes? They can just decide.
There's a judiciary, yes. They're pirates, Nick.
The pirate tribunal, right?
Jesus, Nick. They're pirates. They're not masons. Come on.
They actually covered that in the Johnny Depp movie. They have to get the pieces of eight, right? And they get together, and Keith Richards is there, and then they have to talk about pirate names or something.
Oh, I didn't see that one. Was that Transcendence?
Yeah, Johnny Depp Transcendence.
As soon as people realized they could get salt from the ocean, it sorted itself out.
I've never gotten fresh salt from the ocean.
I think people were like, man, like everybody knew someone that had died in the salt wars. And they're like, well, you can just get the shit from the ocean? Boy, don't I feel silly now. Oh, what have I done?
Such a rare and precious resource.
I think I've forced myself to lose, Nick.
What is happening today with you?
With my...
Did you play too much Isaac?
With my Ipecac, I used, Card Against Humanity on a huge room, and I don't know that I can get out of it, because every time I shoot I'm gonna hit myself.
Stop hitting yourself.
I can't. That's the perfect one. I can't believe you've done this.
That actually could have been from 2003.
It might be in there. Yeah, 2004 is really where like YTMND started to take off. NL, use Ghost Baby. Well, I can't use Ghost Baby, but, like, not, you know, shoot. Oh, okay, I see. Actually, I'm gonna live. I'm gonna live, Nick.
What year did that kid go to the dentist?
Oh, that was, like, 2008, dog.
Oh, shit.
David at the dentist? That kid's still in his jammies.
What year did the kid get the N64 for Christmas?
Oh, that might be, like, 04, 05.
All right, that was my best attempt. Thank you, Chaotic Catalyst, for your subscription very much.
04, you started talking about, like, candy. You're the man now, dog, and, like,
Yeah, Sean Connery's funny again.
Captain Jean-Luc Picard. Thank God I took... Oh, there's another card against humanity.
I give so few shits that I just didn't even go to the item room on this floor. Whatever.
Wow. Jeez, look at this badass.
Yeah, I'm just trying to speedrun now.
2003 was the year of Badger? Oh, yeah. That's true.
Mushroom.
Yeah, that was back in the day. That was like jib-jab shit, too. Like, 1 year prior to the U.S. presidential campaign. You have, like, John Kerry and George W. Bush doing a funny dance.
Oh, he was a flip-flopper. I remember that.
The power of the internet!
The internet is not a big truck. You can't go dumping things on it.
I don't remember that.
You gotta shoot a poker chip through it when the tubes get clogged up.
Oh, okay, yes. I remember that. I believe 06 we're looking at, like, Charlie bit my finger.
When did the O-Long Johnson cat get involved?
What the fuck is Long Johnson cat?
The cat that goes, no, 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 the no, no, no cat.
I have never seen this no, no, no cat.
No fucking way.
Is that the one that Rob does all the time?
Yeah. You haven't seen No No?
I don't think I've seen No 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 Cat.
Yeah, it sounds weird when you say two no's. I prefer the three, actually.
Oh, that's true. 2004 was also Howard Dean's, his scream.
Oh, that was a good one, actually. I remember that
one. Cost him presidential campaign because he was too enthusiastic. Which is how you know elections are decided by the issues.
What other ones were there?
Not that I'm being cynical. I'm out, man.
Chad, I'm as shocked as you are that he hasn't seen the Don Piano cat.
Is it called No No No? Is it called Don Piano? What?
It's about five.
Old Long Johnson
memes.
Cat? How many names does this thing have?
He's got a lot. He says all of these things in rapid succession because he's a cat that gets scratched and he likes it a lot.
Hey, NL, name a Goldie Hawn movie. The Honeymooners. No, wait. What's that one with Steve Martin?
I don't know. Are they seriously reminiscing over memes? Yes. Yes, they are.
This is the only way we can bond as a society.
They're a cultural touchstone. We've established this.
They're a cultural touchstone. Yeah, the Wilhelm screen. That was huge back in 1804. And also still now, I suppose. Ah!
That was... 2004 was the start of Numa Numa.
That's true. Yeah, okay. Sounds legit.
I feel like Numa Numa kicked off the whole damn thing, really.
Red versus blue. Don't know if those are...
Nobody cares about that.
Don't know if those are, you know, necessarily in the same meme camp. They're more of just like a piece of media, but...
It's like a side meme.
Oh, jeez, I don't even talk about that. New sub sound. No, it's... It's not a new sub sound.
I'm gonna rip your innards out through your bunghole!
The old sub sound is perfect. Macabre Beef, thank you very much for the subscription.
I wish there was a way we could sort of streamlined have it be that there could be custom sub sounds that people vote on, and then like it automated just shows up as the sound.
I don't mean this to be dismissive, Nick.
Yeah.
But the grandiose plan that you have devised basically saves you one click.
No, I gotta, like, clip out the bit I want, and then I've gotta set it up, and then I've gotta put it in OBS. It's like a whole thing.
It's not really like a whole thing, though, is it?
It's more work than you made it sound like.
I think you just make a straw poll, and then whenever one wins, you just record, like, your own take of that, and then...
Well, I don't even know which ones are gonna be in the
running. Well, then you gotta figure that out one way or the other.
Yeah, my run, by the way, is a grenade minigun. I don't know if you care about
your
that.
Your old Libra, I guess, has you firing, like, super fast.
Super fast, high arcing Ipecac shots. They do quite a bit of damage, actually.
Chat, are you going to spend your whole life worrying about keys? When do you... You're just going to die someday anyway. If you waste a couple of keys, here it's not go. Like you get a scoreboard when you die. It says, hey, look, you didn't waste that many keys in Isaac.
You don't know that for a fact.
LOL, use 5 keys by skipping golden. Yo, I used the Bible so that I didn't need to waste that many keys, you ding-dongs. I did it with style points.
You Mad Bro started in 2003. That was a classic.
You Mad Bro started in 2003. Jesus. That's just become part of the vernacular now. That's like, oh, I don't want to keep how to jump.
Can you believe there were days before, like, hit markers and Snoop Dogg and glasses falling down? Dank, just as a concept, didn't really enter the same kind of conversation.
Yeah, that kind of bubbled.
MLG, no scopes.
Percolated under the public consciousness until a little later.
Yeah, percolated is a good choice of words there.
I really like percolation. Yesterday, I reached rock bottom. I made coffee, but I put the water in the coffee pot instead of pouring it in the tank at the back. And then I went to the bathroom. I came out like 10 minutes later with like a pot of lukewarm water and a lot of coffee smoke in the air. And I poured the water in the back of the coffee machine and it just belched like hot steam with old coffee smell right into my face. And I was like, oh, this is... I hurt myself today.
Have you ever accidentally put instant coffee into a coffee machine thinking it was grounds?
Jesus Christ, no.
Did you know it actually doesn't do anything bad?
Does it just make instant coffee?
It just makes instant coffee.
It's like artisan instant coffee?
Yeah, well, it's like through an extra process that's not necessary, but yeah. It's really not a problem at all.
Here's some things I don't understand about the new meme generation, Nick.
Okay.
What is shade?
Oh, that's throwing shade at someone when you're disrespecting them in a way.
That's shade is disrespect. Because it's like you're blocking their sun or something.
You're blocking their sun. You're blocking their sunshine, yeah.
Okay. Back in my day, we talked about Stealing Sunshine. It was a classic song by Canadian band Len. I'd spin you a yarn about that, but we've already been down that road.
Yeah.
What is your side, bitch?
Your mistress, I guess.
Oh, okay. So she's on the side.
What did you think it meant?
I have no idea. That's why I'm asking.
Oh. Well, I think we cleared that one
okay.
up pretty easily.
I don't know. I think that might be up on the level now.
It used to be fuckboy was a big problem for you, but you sorted that out pretty well.
Fuckboy, when people said, it's just like a male bitch. I was like, okay. I get it.
When did Do You Even Lift start? That's got to be an old one.
Yeah, that was a while ago, I think. NL is an old man now. I don't know what this stuff means, man.
Was Rickroll back in 2003?
No, I'm feeling like that's an 05 banger. Everyone remembers where they were when they got Rickrolled for the first time.
I still get Rickrolled pretty regularly.
Really?
Sometimes you just don't expect it at all. It's like, there it is again.
Yeah, but now if you're getting Rickrolled, you're getting Rickrolled by like a 30-year-old. It's like
I'm
the dude
not mad about it either.
It's the dude in your office who thinks he's the coolest dude in the office because he's only like 8 years behind the times on jokes. He's like, check this out, dog. David Hasselhoff's drunk and eating a cheeseburger. You're like, oh, come on,
man. Well, that's pretty shocking, though.
Come on, dog.
Guy's not at the height of his career anymore.
Well, not at the moment. Then he was on, like, America's Got Talent or something.
It's usually the dance one. They always, pretty much always dance.
They do a lot of dancing.
Is Nick going to start reading all my messages again? Nah, not today.
Oh, snap. I'm not taking the D4 chat. If you quote Shia LaBeouf at me. Well, we gotta remember where we were when Shia LaBeouf meme became famous.
The actual cannibal Shia LaBeouf or
no,
some
that,
other
that one's show? Like a...
That's newish.
It's, well, sort of.
Well, it's relatively compared to what we just were talking
it's
about.
It's like in the public consciousness, but that like Just Do It one is definitely, that's everywhere, man.
Well, you know he put that like 20-minute video of him against a green screen saying weird shit, right?
Yeah, that's the one.
He asked people to do that. It was basically his own PR thing.
It worked?
Yep.
I know even Steve... Were you trying to hipster me over the fucking early 2000s Disney Channel? I know about Even Stevens, okay? Nobody's getting the government grant for being the first person to say, yeah, but what about Even Stevens, okay? We all remember Shia LaBeouf and Christy Carlson Romano. It's not a it's a pre-Lizzie McGuire era Disney Channel. Everyone remembers it. We were all there. But if you remember Even Stevens, well, you weren't really there, were you?
Weren't you?
Exactly.
Oh. I guess that makes sense.
When was the Hammer Time meme created? That was like 91.
That wasn't even a meme. That was just he wrote a song.
Yeah, we used to just call them like songs back then. We've come a long way. Well, yeah, but what about Even Stevens? What about it? It's a television phenomenon. Anyway.
You on your run yet?
No, I'm gonna win probably, but I'm in a weird place. Not just
why,
because
you
we've
tired
been...
or like what are you feeling about it?
Well, like I'm probably gonna win. How's your run going?
I'm fighting Isaac.
You're fighting Isaac.
I've got a lot of bombs to shoot at him, so that feels neat.
Recently, though, you were like, I didn't even go to the item room on that floor.
What?
Have you made so much progress in such a short amount of time?
That was on like depths 2.
Yeah,
I'm
that was.
Gonna rip you in
I was ahead of
you
at that
hole.
Point. You've made.
I don't
a,
think I follow the timeline, honestly.
You've passed me a little bit. Alexander AT2827, thank you very much for the subscription.
All right, here begins the fall.
How so?
I stood in the corner that the beam happened to come down into, and it killed me, so now I've got to kill him with one hit. There goes that one.
I got faith in you. You get Taurus?
Did I get what?
Taurus?
No.
I got like a sweet library situation.
I might go back and farm for hearts in a minute, because this is just silly. I should be able to do it, though. I just have to stop standing in corners where light beams go.
Yeah. What's your opinion on Back to the Future? 1 is a classic, 2 is like, alright, 3 is not very good.
I like when the kid falls in that thing full of shit.
Is that from, like, all of them?
Yeah, I think yeah, that's from all of them.
I was like, definitely that happens in the first one. It's a classic film moment. Popcorn classic, if you will. And then in the second one, I'm pretty sure there's like some cyber shit or something that falls on one of them.
It's probably like a box full of hoverboards.
Oh, yeah.
Because they're in the future.
But like Back to the Future 3 is real not good. But I kind of feel like if you have a beloved franchise, you get like one shitty movie that you're allowed to like.
I guess so, yeah.
Like you're allowed to like either Terminator 3 or Terminator Salvation. As long as you go, well, you know, I know they're not that good, but I kind of like Terminator Salvation. Then I'll be like, you know, it's bad, but you're allowed that. But if you go, I really like Terminator 3 and Terminator Salvation, you cross the fucking line.
I happen not to like either. Where does that put me?
I guess
I like
you should,
two a lot.
You should see Terminator Genesis this weekend, I guess.
Okay.
I kind of like Terminator 3 a little, but Terminator Salvation was hot garbage.
Yeah, I didn't like either one.
Terminator 3 is not amazing, but I think Terminator 3 is my, like, well, you earned one.
Fucking hell.
It's like having, like, you know, if you're, like, a valedictorian, and you've consistently put up, like, really good marks, and you just kind of, like, phone one assignment in. I think the teacher has a little bit of an obligation to, like, give you at least a B+.
Chad, do you want me to just suicide myself on this? I can pick up Cricket's body and rubber cement, and that'll just be the end of my run. Guaranteed it. Do you care?
And
I'll do it.
Under no circumstances are you allowed to like X-Men 3. This is correct, yes. X-Men 3 is... It's weird because the X-Men films are good. X-Men 3 is really bad, though. It transcends it.
All right, kiss this run goodbye. Here we go.
Good luck, Nick.
This is the stupidest shit.
I like The Matrix 3, but not 2. I think The Matrix 1 is enough of a cultural touchstone, if you will, that you're allowed to like one of the Matrix films that is not The Matrix 1. But not both. I saw X-Men 3 in theaters twice. That is, jeez. That's something right there.
I don't think there's any way that anyone could beat anything with this.
I've definitely had some losing runs with that combination.
I don't care if you shoot one single shot at a time, I don't think you can get out of this alive, ever.
Libra's been a huge help for you as well, I'm sure.
I might be able to just beat this one room, and that'll be it. Be good.
I like Spider-Man 3 and not Spider-Man 2. That is incorrect. You are wrong. Spider-Man 3 is very bad, and Spider-Man 2 is a goddamn classic.
new challenge run. You don't want this as your challenge run. If you can beat two floors with this, I would be impressed.
Are we allowed to, like, Phantom Menace and Attack of the Clones, or do you only get one? You only get one on that one, no doubt. Nick, what's your go-to? If you had to choose Phantom Menace or Attack of the Clones.
Phantom Menace.
I'm with you, man. Attack of the Clones is just real goddamn boring.
At least there was a couple of cool lightsaber battles, and Darth Maul was, like, you know, prominently introduced in the one I mentioned. In the other one, it was just, like, really bad love story and also cringeworthy dialogue. Not really too many cool fight scenes. I don't really know what we wanted out of that.
What did... Someone in here said something that I found irredeemable, but now I've lost it.
Phantom Menace, no contest. Attack of the Clones is the best of the prequels, says Matrix Revived.
I saw the latest Brendan Fraser mummy movie. Thank you for clarifying which actor was the lead in that, by the way. In theaters twice. Don't ask me why. You don't understand. You have to be asked why in this situation. Because I also saw, what is it, like Curse of the fucking Chinese Dragon? Whatever. Was Curse of the Dragon's Tomb? Was that it? I saw it in theaters once. I had a great reason. I was like, this movie's gonna suck, and it's Friday, and I'm off work. Hey, buddy, you wanna come over and, like, get shithouse drunk and then go see the Mummy movie with Brendan Fraser? The latest in the Mummy franchise with Brendan Fraser? And he said yes, and then we did it.
It's a compelling argument. I don't see who wouldn't do that.
Curse of the Dragon
Tattoo. I would even go see the Scorpion King if I was shithouse drunk with you.
Yeah, man.
Perfect sense. CG is so bad in that movie.
I have actually never seen The Scorpion King, so I would be like the perfect person to see this with.
I've never even seen No No Cat.
Yeah, I haven't seen anything, apparently.
Come on.
Oh, someone said, I remember what they said now. I like Batman and Robin, but not Batman Begins. That's just like, you are clearly making that up, because there is no person on Earth who shares that opinion with you. Even Joel Schumacher would be like, that guy is crazy.
I need to hear more about this explanation. You've got to justify that. You can't just let that stand in the air.
It's like it's a huge insult to Batman Begins. Whether or not you like Batman Begins exists in a vacuum. But then when you say, I like Batman and Robin and not Batman Begins, that's just the end of your life. Like, I don't get it.
Maybe they like the really over-the-top ridiculous dialogue in Batman and Robin. Like a cartoony kind of thing. Because it was almost like a living cartoon with Arnold Schwarzenegger, which is just absurd. Maybe look at it like a comedy.
I could see you saying, like, if that's the case, you got to preface that. You got to be like, I like this, but it's trash. I got a lot of movies like that.
Right.
So I'm trying the rubber cement run as well, Nick, but I didn't get Cricket's Body. You got Cricket's Body?
Cricket's Body, Ipecac, Libra. So basically soy milk, essentially, just shooting straight ahead of you. And then splitting into four and all of them bounce.
George Clooney is a better Batman than Christian Bale. You know, that's irrelevant because George Clooney was in the worst Batman movies. Well, okay, admittedly some of those Adam West ones are bad, but they're enjoyable for the wrong reasons, I guess. It's like the shit where people are like, oh, well, Pierce Brosnan, he was in, like, the worst Bond movies, but he's the best Bond. Sure, but he's, like, in the worst Bond movies, you know?
I don't really understand that, actually, to be honest.
People are like, well, he looks like James Bond. And it totally isn't because I just grew up with him being James Bond, so he automatically became, like, my...
Yeah, he looks like him to you.
Exactly. Timothy
Dalton. And I can agree, because actually that's true for me, too.
Yeah, man, we played so much GoldenEye.
GoldenEye was the formative Bond experience that made people interested in Bond.
Well,
at my age.
Yes, there. That's true.
It was a cultural touchstone, if you want to really be honest.
Oh, man, this is... Chat is having a field day with this Batman James Bond discussion. I kind of feel like saying Brosnan's movie sucked, but except for GoldenEye. GoldenEye is always accepted here because it's the greatest. But Brosnan was a good Bond is for people that actually like The World Is Not Enough and Tomorrow Never Dies. And maybe even Die Another Day, although that's irredeemable. And then they go, well... I can't say that because I'll be shunned from popular society. But instead...
I don't think I liked any of the ones you just mentioned, actually.
Yo, GoldenEye, though.
Other than GoldenEye.
GoldenEye is amazing.
Look at all these cat pieces, guys. Filling up on cat pieces right now.
I have seen the Earthquake movie twice in theaters. You talking about San Andreas, mate?
I'm your age, Nick. I was interested in Bombed years before GoldenEye. It was written B-O-M-D. That's why I read that that way.
Bombed.
Yeah, no, I don't doubt that there probably are people that don't agree with me. And that's fine.
It's not.
I'm just saying, making a generalization, that's all.
GoldenEye is fine at best. You are high as hell.
It's one of those things I think we celebrate being ignorant about how good it really is.
No, GoldenEye is dope, man.
Yeah, it's great. It's just like, we know.
Yeah, I don't trust your reaction there, my friend. Yeah, it's great. No, GoldenEye is a classic.
Look, I like it. It's just there's nostalgia goggles, and I don't think anybody is going to.
I saw it for the first time when I was 22 years old.
Oh. All right. Well, I guess you disallow that.
Yo, you don't need to be 15 to get into that Xenia on a top action, man.
She was on a top of something there, wasn't
like
she?
Like often. With surprising regularity.
I believe she broke a man's neck with her thighs.
I don't know. Yeah, you know, definitely there was a lot of neck breaking. Most of the men died in nebulous ways. Just, like, general crushing.
Uh-huh.
She'd be, like, having sexual intercourse with him and squeeze her legs real tight, and they just pop like a hot dog.
The femoral artery, man. She goes right for that. Not a lot of people do these days.
Yeah, I've never done it.
You should try it. If you want to kill someone, do sex.
I don't think I do.
Thanks very much, Feneri, for your subscription. How about some rock kitty cats for you? Rock meow.
Ah. I gotta see Skyfall again. I saw it on a plane, so I don't remember anything about it.
Was that the one that was just a big car commercial, or was that all of them?
I don't know how to answer that question at all.
It was a little loaded, sorry.
Was that the one that was just a car commercial, or was that all of them? No? Maybe? I don't know, man.
Hot dog. Yeah, Rock Kitty Cat won't get you the emote, I'm sorry.
I am almost fucking done with this run, finally.
I'm glad you lived.
Are you gonna live?
No, I already died a while ago.
Oh, okay.
I started an Azazel run. I've just been collecting cat pieces because it's a fun
game. I didn't realize. I'm sorry.
Okay. Shoes on the other foot, mate.
I guess so, yeah. There you go. That's a win. Thanks for watching. I almost showed off the potential streak there for a minute. We're playing that Docket game next.
Docket game.
Docket game. Quack, quack. It's Duck Game. It's just on the docket. We'll be back in 3 minutes. Thanks for watching. Don't go anywhere.
See you soon. Oh, Flush. I love this item.
Flush?
Goodbye. It's the thing that turns people into poop.
Oh, yeah. That is
it's
a real
like the
item.
Toilet handle.
You did not get the name wrong.
Yeah, that's what it's actually called. It's not a great item. All right. Bye, cat pieces. You've been fun. Boop.
Duck game better fucking happen this time, is what chat says.
Fine.
Jeez. Chat, don't accidentally ruin chat. I like that one as well.
I'm gonna rip you in and zap through your bunghole.
Crimson Howler, thanks for the subscription. I'm gonna go to the bathroom. I'll be right back.
All
right.
Have fun. I always do. I'm Northern Lion. Hey, so thank you to Fuzzy Wolf for the $1.69 donation. When are you guys going to play Ape Escape 2 on stream? It doesn't sound like the usual person that asked that. Probably not too soon, unfortunately, but it's up to Ryan, not me. So if it was up to me, we'd be playing Demon's Crest and Lost Planet 2 on today's stream. Thank you, Jordan B95, for the $5.69 donation. Why are the Roundtable podcasts 250 megabytes? It kills my data package when I'm not on Wi-Fi. I can't bear compress them better. That's a question you'd have to ask him, because honestly, I'm not appraised of the minutiae of how that all works, actually, of what he's uploading. But I could pass that question along. Now that I know that that's happening. So thank you for letting me know, and thank you for the donation. I'll look into it. Thank you also, Brandon J., for the $5 donation. Hey, Nick, just wanted to extend my thanks from Savannah, Georgia, for entertaining me through art school and tough nights. Big thanks. Well, thank you very much. I'm a fan of Georgia myself. I have relatives there. Thank you also, Sweet Boys, for the $3.50 donation. Hey, Nick, the NLSS has been with me for the past 2 years, and I'm moving 30 miles from home, not knowing anyone, but you guys will keep me company. Oh, that's a nice story. We're happy to keep you company, and thank you for being here for 2 years. Also, thank you for the donation. That's very nice. So we're going to turn on the duck, and we're going to get Rob. Hello.
Hi. Are you talking to me?
Yeah, I just said hello.
Yo.
Hey, Rob.
How's it going?
You want to play GoldenEye 007 as the Tournament of Shame?
Yes, except I'm terrible at that game.
You don't have to use the C button as anymore. You just use a stick.
Oh, you mean the... What
they
was that one
it,
called?
Right? Yeah.
No, I mean the original.
You still have to use the C buttons, though.
Yeah.
No, map into an analog stick.
Oh, this guy's using emulation. I didn't realize we were endorsing, you know, gray market ethics here.
I don't know. I own a cartridge. I think I own, like, several, actually.
It doesn't matter, man. With Nintendo, you can't legally stream their games.
Oh, yeah, Nintendo's
or they'll put you in prison themselves. They'll put you in Nintendo prison.
Yeah, Nintendo prison is terrible because it's a love hotel, except it's all with, like, Mario characters. So.
Yeah, though, look, there's no warden. It's a Wario-den.
You know, you went for it.
Several of the letters matched. I had to at least try.
It was a good effort. You
Somebody's got to take these chances.
That's what's
glad it wasn't me.
I have to raise you guys on Skype.
Raise your Skype.
We've come a long, long way together.
All right, I'll get a room set
the
up here.
The hard times and the good.
I have to I get it.
Celebrate
like
you,
joke.
Baby. I have to pray, raise you like I should.
Like I should.
Fuck! I blew it!
Alright.
I'm ready to quack.
Alright, I'm getting you in a moment.
Yeah.
Okay.
You can join on me now.
Okay.
I'm gonna rip your hands out through your bunghole!
I will do this thing that you say.
Gamer Muse, thank you for the subscription. You didn't need to invite me, Nick. I'm already there.
I didn't know you were adding me already, so.
Nick, did you like how you told me to listen to Daughters today? And then I sent you that picture of Daughtry?
It was close. Did you listen to Daughters? I want to know what your opinion is.
No, instead, when I said The Coors, I just went and listened to that song Breathless for like an hour. It's really bad. You know the one.
I figured you'd like Fur Beach, and the fact that the album is called Canada Songs, it might make you feel patriotic.
Actually, the album is called, like, Everlasting Love, and the song is called Breathless. It's by The Coors.
Talking about Daughters.
It's the one that goes, go on, leave
I'm
me breathless.
I'm gonna rip you in and zap through your bunghole!
Eddie Metal Freak. Thank you for the subscription.
Duck Game!
Okay. Wow! Oh, jeez. Something's not right.
Yeah! We killed each other. Alright.
So I looked into the level editor. I actually made a couple of levels for this, and
ooh.
I'm really excited about them adding the feature of online levels that we can play, because I will absolutely have a pack ready for us.
You'll have a what?
I'll have a pack of levels ready for us to play, and those
will
be a lot of fun.
That's awesome. I didn't try... Is the level editor...
It's not easy to use, really, no.
Whoa!
Good or
that's perfect timing. That's what you get from the Tournament of Shame champion.
Yeah, that's true.
Yeah. What do you want?
How do you feel about Men in Black 2?
It is a terrible movie.
Yeah!
There's a few jokes in there that are pretty funny.
Are you gonna mention the Balchinians?
Well, yeah, obviously. That's the one. Oh, what? No!
Oh,
yeah,
you got
gotcha.
Me. Nick is gonna make only net gun levels.
Actually, and that's the other... Yeah, he really is. That's the other thing.
I'm
is,
gonna rip you in and zap.
I'm gonna shoot y'all!
Fuck.
Oh, I'm on fire. I'm on fire.
Yes!
Alright. there's the other joke with the, what's his face? Will Smith is, like, trying to tell Kay about how he used to love being flushed.
Will Smith isn't in that movie.
In Men in Black 2?
Are you thinking of Tommy Lee Jones?
Wait, what? Will Smith is in Men in Black 2.
He's not in Men in Black 2. He's in 3 and 1.
He's in 3 and 1. It's like a Hugh Jackman situation.
You guys are freaking me out here.
Will Smith is not in Men in Black 2. Just like it's an Iron Man situation. He was replaced by Terrence Howard.
What is he talking about?
I don't know.
Get away
from me. No, I was talking to Brian. What are you talking about?
I'm gonna kill you both. But the flush me scene where he's like, did we used to do this a lot? And then Will Smith's like, yeah, all the time. You'd be like, flush me, Jay, flush me. And I'd be like, nah.
Yeah, that was a good moment.
What?
That's the whole joke. It was fantastic, all right? Oh, you're
Will
not
Smith
gonna
burn wasn't
me.
In that
Will Smith wasn't in Men in Black 2.
Kill you all.
You're thinking of Tommy Lee Jones.
You're thinking of Tommy Lee Jones, obviously.
Maybe David Cross? David Cross was in it?
Actually,
didn't
it was
they
David
have
Cross
the jackass guy was in it too, right?
Johnny Knoxville.
Yeah, Johnny Knoxville was in it.
He was in that one.
You're thinking of Johnny Knoxville.
My mind right now is not... It's not unfucked.
I can't believe that worked.
Well, what's happening?
Here? I hate this map more than anything.
Yeah, this map's garbage. How do you use the so how do you use the maps that you create out of curiosity?
You don't. It's, the feature is not enabled, which is why I said that if it is enabled, I will be happy to provide you with maps.
Ah. Oh, you burned me! I will burn you back!
I mean, like, it's
I will
not
burn
developed
you back.
Yet.
Oh, that's garbage.
The developer's working on like all kinds of different ideas that'll be implemented later. So this game will have longevity, I believe.
I am a net. I am a man of nets.
I don't know how this works, but this person... Oh, you scare me. This person in chat was correct. Javier Bardem should have been in Men in Black 2. I don't care what role he's going to play. Just put him in there.
Was he trying to think of Josh Brolin and got the wrong
No, name? I think he's just like, you know, apropos of nothing. It would be sweet if Javier Bardem was in Men in Black 2. I agree.
I think Javier Bardem should be in all movies.
Almost
really.
Every movie. Sex in the City 2, Javier Bardem. He can play the sex.
I don't know who that is.
New York.
You don't know Javier Bardem? You never saw No Country for Old Men?
He's in No Country for Old Men.
I think I saw that. I don't think I remember who that is, though.
He played the
country. He's got the
country.
Silent Shotgun.
Javier?
Yeah, he played country.
He played country.
He was country? Which one was Old Men?
Tommy Lee Jones.
Tommy Jones, actually.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, it was. You're not wrong about that. Oh. Classic Old Men.
He would be awesome in Star Wars. Don't even tell me that someone who's Spanish can't be in Star Wars. Have you seen, like, the freaking diversity in the Star Wars cast? They've got Twi'leks and Banthas and stuff like that.
Guys,
like, oh,
I can't
that guy.
Wear the hat. It's too hot right now.
Fucking John Boyega is going to be, like, presumably the character.
Oh, yeah.
Sean?
Yeah, John Boyega.
Bolegna. Who is John Boyega?
He was in Attack the Block. Did you guys ever see Attack the Block?
Oh, yeah, yeah, I did see
Attack
the Block.
Is that one about the stepping up to the street? Do you have to dance?
No,
yeah,
it's an alien invasion movie.
What? No, you said block. Street. Whatever.
Oh, God.
21 Block Street.
Okay. I will take this victory. That's not very deserving, but I will take it.
John Boyega. I really like that.
What the fuck? The door is blocked on the right. There's a desk in the fucking way.
Will NL complete his Fallout series? Yeah, that's the intention. I mean, there's like... Oh! What is this?
I don't know what that gun does.
You're welcome.
There's five more episodes coming... Oh, it broke the door. It attacked the block! There's five more episodes coming out this week, and then on Sunday I'm planning to play it again.
Oh, you fucking
I'm gonna rip
your
innards out through your bunghole!
Duck her in the bunghole. Thank you very much for the subscription. Duck Game Strats here. Playing dead makes you immune to fire. Oh, shit.
Does it really?
That's gonna change the game.
Ah, I've been armored! This is my plan all along! I shall cut you to death.
Oh, it didn't work!
Oh, I have no armor anymore.
I'm
going to
rip
your
innards out through your bunghole.
Oh, he blocked it with a sword. Oh, that's bad for business. Oh, Chronic 8745, thank you for the subscription.
Quack, 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 quack. Now, what were we saying? Oh, you're in a fucking tree. No!
You will never get this.
God damn it.
You will never get this.
Oh, God. Nick is... Oh, my God.
I hate Netgun Nick.
It's
what
you
is
know,
this?
It's not just the web gun. It's that he knows how to get the web gun on every level. He knows where they are.
There's not that many levels.
That's true.
Damn it.
You can live in a net, and it will not kill you.
What are you? What's happening here? What is going on?
Oh, I died in that? Are you kidding me?
Ooh, come here.
Oh, I had no body armor.
NL just won a net round? It's been known to happen occasionally.
I never win net rounds.
Not oh, I hate these one-way doors.
Wait, why can't I?
Oh, I knew it!
I got the armor and I was intending to jump right after.
I was 100%.
The online custom map thing is already in the beta of the game.
Oh, it's in the beta
I don't have the beta, though.
Well, yeah, you can just put up
how do
a beta
I get
branch.
That, bro, duck?
I guess you just go to betas. Maybe we should do that.
It's not in there, I don't think. Is it?
I haven't looked, so I don't know.
I want to play custom maps online real bad. I'll make like 20 of them tonight.
I love how you can interact with NL so easily. You know, you've got the meta wrong. You're supposed to say Northern Lion doesn't read chat. Even though it's the only thing I've read in the past 10 years. That
I started reading books.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What you reading?
It's pretty fun.
Have you read The Martian yet?
No, I want to, though.
Yeah, I read it. I read it last year. I'm not trying to, you know, be a before it was greenlit into a famous multi-movie film with Matt Damon. It's pretty good.
Oh, you had the armor.
Oh, that was pretty cool.
Of course
cool.
I had the armor. I also learned a little secret about ragdolling in this game.
Did you learn that it's living in a movie and also Santa's little cutie? Daddy's little cutie?
I should have stayed as a limp body.
Ragdoll.
No, I was still going to shoot you in a second.
Living in a movie. Yeah, is it Santa's little cutie?
Why did I not die there?
I'm your friend!
All right. Oh, God.
Ragdoll. This is the song called Ragdoll.
Is that Cat Dog?
No, that's Aerosmith's magnum opus, Ragdoll.
What about Cat Dog?
It's about Tomo.
I get it.
You want Nick or Ryan's body?
That's not a body. It's not me anymore. It's just meat.
Did I tell you guys yesterday that I had quail? Oh, you motherfucker.
You did? Yeah, you were talking about quail endlessly. To the point where most people were like, oh my god, just
we're really
up.
Sick about hearing your quail.
Don't you can never shoot a gun again on this level. Oh, what have you done?
That's what always happens. You just wait.
Oh, god damn it.
Would you recommend The Martian to normal people who don't like science? Well, first off, I take a little issue with your use of normal. Secondly, sure, it's pretty readable. I mean, like, I don't understand anything about astronomy or, you know, astrophysics, but I still, Oh, fudge!
I didn't know which side of the meta we were on.
I'm happy about how that turned out.
It's still pretty good. It's a good book. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars on goodbooks.org.
Tomatoes.
Oh, God.
There should be a Rotten Tomatoes for books.
Booknatoes.
Yeah, because, you know, movies are made out of tomatoes, which is why it's named that. Oh, jeez.
Oh, there's a mine! All right, you know what? I want this.
Is NL playing Rocket League? Yes, I am, and so are these jabronis.
Not right now.
Playing after
this. Now we're playing Duck Game.
Oh, no, no!
Oh, I have a nate.
Rocket League. Oh.
Gotcha.
Fuck.
Shot too many times.
No, it wasn't good reads. It was goodbooks.gov.
Rotten booknatoes.
Uh-oh.
What is this? Shoes!
Suicide gun. God damn it.
Oh, okay. Goodbye.
That was a stupid round.
Yeah.
Nobody did anything.
Pardon me. I put on some shoes.
It's all about the shoes. Oh, no.
He's got a net.
Arm.
Ooh.
Oh, James!
James! Franco!
Oh, he didn't do it!
I'm gonna have to re-net him now. James Franco!
God. He's out of nets? There's no more nets?
It's alright.
What am I doing?
Oh, he's got a machine gun. Ho ho ho. This is Hans Gruber over here.
Come get a taste, bitch.
You know where this is gonna go, right? All the way to the bank. Because you know what? This was just to distract you.
Come get me.
Uh-oh. Now I'm a real danger again.
You can move that box and try to get like a... Oh, he got him. Yeah. Wow. Wow.
I thought Goodbye. I was being under there.
Sober day.
Oh, I hate this level, actually.
Yeah, I'm not a huge fan of this one.
Oh, one of the worst.
Heal! Heal!
I disarmed you!
By heal, I mean reload. Disarming!
No!
Disarm!
I have a third time! I'm not
the only one with a real weapon, and I actually died. There's an AK right there. That's a lot better.
Come here! Woo! Okay, I will... Oh, he's got an AK-47? Oh, no.
You straight up lose. Just kill yourself when somebody gets the AK.
I didn't even know there was an AK in this game. Is this DLC? Yeah. AK-47 DLC? Just...
Are you going to waste all the nets like a scrub?
Absolutely. Get out of my dreams, get into my net.
I don't know what this is. Oh, Earthworm Gym Gun.
Yep, that's pretty good.
I hate that a lot.
That spray control. Yeah, I've been playing Global Offensive for days. I think Mick passed me. I think he's got a few more. Oh, I thought you were... I forgot you were Frog, Nick. Never mind. I was sandbagging accidentally.
Get that.
Wow. Someone said, sometimes when I watch this, I wonder myself, how the hell did Rob win the tourney? Hey, I got 9, motherfucker. That's only 2 points of difference.
People like to shit on Rob. I don't really get why, though.
Is it just me, or is NL the first to throw the rock no matter what player he is? That's actually true. That's freaking me out.
Oh, yeah.
Well, how does that happen? Maybe Duck Mask is like early in the rotation or something.
I was gonna say we should try. Oh well, I got one fire thing off. We should maybe try the beta after this round if you guys want.
No.
See if we can mix maps in
there.
That's
just gonna be a problem. No, okay. I need to pre-approve that.
Yeah, you're probably right. Oh, he's made him into yourself.
Can't mind control me.
Oh, Spartan Laser. Spartan Laser or Flamethrower. Spartan.
Wait, did I?
You didn't do it.
I thought, all right, that's okay. I was a little confused, to be honest.
2 points of losing.
Oh.
Don't, Rob, you're playing into his hands.
No, I want your body.
Thank you.
Oh, all right, that's what you get.
I shouldn't have taken your body.
You could have lived.
I know. It was my error. I shouldn't have gone against the Netlord. Oh, that was like some Last Samurai shit.
Hi-yo.
That is what the Last Samurai did. He actually threw his sword.
Yep.
It was really strange.
And then they were like, well, that's not fair. And that's why he was the last of the samurai.
Whoever can find the right portal.
I know which one it is. I just don't want to get close enough. Wait, it's not that one? Oh, I got to be on the other side of it. That's why. Wait.
Oh, yeah, that's the wrong one.
Okay, what?
I was scratching my hand. This is the perfect strategy.
Oh, this is a disaster.
I hate my positioning at the beginning.
Yep. Little does he know I unpinned that grenade. Alright.
You had me running scared there, Rob.
Has anyone checked if Fallout Shelter is on Android yet? Because I really want to play that game.
I said it was going to be a couple months.
Couple months? it's an Android. They should make them themselves.
What?
Sorry, what?
The cook.
Is an android? They should make them themselves?
Yeah, it's a robot. Robot makes them. Oh, no.
Robot makes them.
Robot makes them.
I'm sorry, I was thinking other things while I was saying that.
You're having a full-on Josh moment right now.
it happens. We're fucked. Nope. Okay.
His plan's actually pretty good.
My plan's better.
Nope.
Don't.
That's not happening at all.
I thought I could duck under it.
Duck game.
Duck
under.
Game, not stand.
The arc shot. Oh, this fucking disaster piece. Get him! Oh no, I failed.
God damn it, no.
I failed you.
God.
Yeah, oh.
Yeah.
Oh, the arc shot.
Oh, they said it's coming out in August? Okay, cool.
Don't take this the wrong way, but is it not just like a time management diner dash thing?
No, I mean, better than that.
Yeah, it's like It's like an XCOM, you know, base.
What? It's XCOM?
No, it's really not quite an XCOM.
It's not anything like XCOM, but I mean, it has the XCOM, like, beehive base thing.
It has what? A thing where you
Did
build into
Did we play
a
the
mountain,
same XCOM?
Oh, yeah, I can't believe that actually worked. That was so bad.
There's a lot of beehives in XCOM. That's the thing you're not thinking about, Ryan.
I guess so.
It's the beehive base thing. That's how Jake Solomon describes it. Sorry, I'm like good friends with the developer Jake Solomon. I'm dead.
Who's the developer again?
Jake Solomon?
The
Jake
developer Solomon. Of XCOM. I still can't believe that was a one-man project.
Yeah.
Why did he hear that?
Oh, snap. Fallout Shelter sucks, but it's Fallout. I'm having a really good time with New Vegas. Which I guess is like super not surprising. It's like one of the most beloved games of the maybe ever. Yeah, I should have seen that coming.
Is New Vegas? Oh no.
3 was a lot better though.
All right. I never actually played New Vegas.
Really? Yeah. Oh, you gotta get on it, man.
I don't recommend you get on it. I'm just kidding. You can get on it if you want to get on it.
I don't want to.
What the hell? He was stuck in the wall?
Where is he? Oh,
he's in the bottom left corner. I didn't even know you could stand there.
Oh, man.
All right, that was pretty good.
Look, I'm not taking a horse in the Fallout race yet. I'm like less than 2.5 hours into Fallout New Vegas. So I'm not like... Oh, I'm a convert. You know, Fallout 3 sucks. I gotta finish New Vegas first, but still. Hey, NL, would you like a game of Caravan? No, I would not like a game of Caravan. Get out of here, Chet.
Chet?
Damn it, Chet.
Chet's always talking about Caravan. I really thought I would force you to blow up.
Uh-oh. He knew. Fuck.
I'll take it.
Not too long.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
You know.
Totally.
I'm dead.
Was it worth it?
Nah, really.
Let me work it. Put my thing down, flip it, and reverse it. You're from New York. You should know Missy Elliott.
I mean,
I put my thing down before, absolutely.
Don't do that. it's Ringo, not Chet.
That was good. Oh, that was Ringo, not Chet. That's my mistake. Ringo is the guy. Chet's the store owner. Ringo's the guy who's like, hey, everybody's coming to this town to murder me with their guns. And he's just like, you want to play like a quick game of Caravan? Worth it.
I bet we could do 10 rounds consecutively without hitting anyone or without getting any points.
Oh, no!
It's
a new map, I think. I've never seen it.
I think those, someone told me once that those are like actually like randomly generated maps that the.
Don't do it, man.
That the host can. I don't want to come in here.
Okay. Just kind of bump me a little. I really thought I would hit you out of the sky with that rocket and it would be the greatest thing of all time.
Oh, no. Yep. You can't cancel the reload once you've started reloading.
Yeah, that's when you have to be shot.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
What?
That's not a.
Did you catch my gun?
Don't worry about it.
What's happening?
He's got the net. Shit.
Oh.
Yeah, no, I knew it! My brain parsed it, but it didn't.
That is so next level.
You hit me in between the times and my brain figured it out, but it passed the signal onto my hands. That hurts so badly.
Oh.
I'm a fan of it, to be honest. Oh, good shot.
Stop there. Hey,
oh, Jesus.
Fuckboy Nick abandoned the rocket honor system.
Oh, that was awesome. That was great.
That's some John Woo shit right there.
I want a Rocket League esports team. We're going to be the first world champions.
I can't wait.
Oh, no.
Whoa.
You didn't get a good grip on it. That's okay.
What a choke. Jeez.
Ow.
Fallout 3 is the Spider-Man 3 of video games. Yo, you guys need to figure out what the critical consensus on Spider-Man 3 is, because it's really bad.
Really bad.
Spider-Man 3 is maybe one of the worst movies.
The video game equivalent of Spider-Man 3 is like the fourth Gears of War game or something. Ascension, or what was it? Ascension?
Judgment?
Judgment. Ascension was the fourth God of War.
I don't like this. I don't like this situation.
We were having like a very interesting kind of game here.
Oh, shit.
Is there a good Spider-Man movie? There are two good Spider-Man movies. Well,
yeah.
One good, one great.
Shit, he got it off before I could.
You know what? Spider-Man 2 is arguably better than...